water here. We're gonna hook this up buffet style. All right, so I've got some celery roots. We'll make three little mounds right on this.
Have you ever had celery roots?
You can use a smaller platter, a bigger platter, or even
so. What is celery root?
Individual portions. I don't know.
The celery root, like it was all. I'm gonna hook this up with a gravel side salad, which is gonna be watercress with a cherry tomato vinaigrette. We roasted just a pint of cherry tomatoes, so it kind of highlights the flavor, a little bit of garlic, spinach, virgin olive oil, and also some fresh herb. We're just gonna give this a little toss. I'm gonna pile up some little love right there. Okay, and then we'll scoop out this recipe because it's so tender. All right, it's got a nice little snap to it.
Hello and welcome to Semi Homemade. I'm Sandra Lee, and tonight is all about family night. So I'm going to make a big, fabulous family dinner, garlic lump roast. And alongside that, I have a fantastic fried artichoke heart that is her favorite. It was mine when I was a little girl, too.
You know, I have been cooking and entertaining for years, the traditional way that my grandma taught me. But it is a lot of work to get everything done. So I created shortcuts for myself that all my girlfriends loved, and I'm thrilled to be able to share with you.
I'm going to make a wonderful beef roast today with a tomato madeira. This is so delicious. This is what we're going to use in the slow cooker with the beef roast.
Miles,
Miles, quiet. Shut your bark hole.
Transfer that tart to a dish, Jim.
Why?
Because that's the way it's supposed to be.
Your tart is not ready?
Miles, where's yours?
Well, Miles is downstairs. Oh my goodness, what is it?
Look, we got some blocks.
Oh, look, they have... Oh, that's cute. They have... numbers. Look, D for Doolittle or dog. See the dog? What's your dog's name? What else? Ooh, a drum. You can beat on drum. Yes. And the number 4. C. See the letter C? Yeah. Lincoln, look at your sweet, innocent little face.
He's so cute.
Well, we're going to lie to you, okay? Yeah, for quite a few years we're going to lie to you. And sometimes even threaten you with a lie, that you have to be good. We're going to tell you there's a Santa Claus. Daddy's gonna be in on the lie too. Right, Jim? Right, Jim?
The bacon! The bacon!
Lincoln, I don't think we'll tell you about the Easter Bunny. We don't. Right?
What about, what's that other, that bitch who comes? Teeth.
The tooth fairy?
Yeah.
I just hope he has teeth like me, not like you.
What's the matter with my teeth?
They're small.
My parents never bought me braces.
You're not upset about those braces. What are you talking about? You want this, bud?
Yeah.
introduce me to all your animal heads?
No.
Why? There's one right up there. Don't look. Don't look. There's something behind you.
Stop.
Don't look. Just do that. Look behind you. Don't look.
No,
don't look. There's something behind you. There is. I swear. Christmas fudge. Santa never brought me fudge as a child. No braces, no fudge.
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn king, peace on earth.
I'm over it.
Are you going to tell us the lies that you're going to tell Lincoln?
Lincoln, I'm not going to tell you any lies. I might tell you that your daddy's a great man. I might tell you that Philadelphia is the best place in the world to live. That your grandmothers are great cooks. That you should eat every last Brussels sprout on your plate. I don't want to tell you lies about Santa, but I feel like circumcision and other things that we've already caved in on, that I might have to help propagate that dastardly lie about this white man who lives amongst the Eskimos and midgets. I don't think I want to do the thing about the tooth bitch. We don't even celebrate Easter, buddy. That's just a day we eat ham. It's the face of somebody who's being lied to.
Get it.